Tahrir Square, Pearl Square, the streets of Tunis, Sana'a and Tripoli. Women and men side by side marching together, defying government forces. They're calling for reform and regime change. For years, women in these countries have suffered gender discrimination. Throughout history, they have been marginalized by totalitarian regimes. According to the Arab Human Development Report in 2002, the lack of women's rights was one of the main stumbling blocks hampering the region's progress. But in the past few years, things have changed. Across the Muslim world, women have stepped into the forefront of dangerous anti-regime protests. Women are now actively participating in the pursuit of freedom, dignity, and social justice, shoulder to shoulder with men.
December 15, 2011. The outskirts of Manama. A police officer is dragging a girl on the ground. She is not a criminal. Her name is Zainab Al-Khawaja, a Bahraini human rights activist and the daughter of Abdul Hadi Al-Khawaja, a prominent Bahraini Danish human rights activist. Her name grabbed headlines after she posted tweets online about anti-regime protests in Bahrain. She was arrested three more times when protesting with other women. The Bahraini uprisings were initially aimed at achieving greater political freedom and equality for the majority Shia population, calling for the end of King Hamad's monarchy.
We see here in Bahrain that the media ignored Bahrain. We see that the international bodies, UN and the Security Council, ignored Bahrain for double standards.
More than 100 people have been killed and around 3,000 injured during these uprisings. Many of them, women. This is the mother of fruit seller Mohammad Bouazizi, who immolated himself and set the autocracy of Zain al-Abidin bin Ali in power for 23 years on fire. Arusia Hamemi is a village woman who works on an olive farm. She was accused of initiating the overthrow of Ben Ali's regime by distributing leaflets and belonging to an underground organization.
ديما نبقى كنت خايل ديما نحكي وحدي ديما نتذكر حاجات ديما هكا غصة معناها ما نجمتش نحي. وصلوا بيا 8 متاع الليل للقروان اللي هنا في المنطقة، لقيت قاعة كبيرة فيها بيروات وكل فيها 14 واحد واقفين رجال، معناها بهت معناها كيفاش كل واحد معناها يجيب لي سؤال، واحد يسب فيا، واحد يقول لي كلام معناها خايب ياسر، يتصور ما كنتش نتصور ونسمعك الكلام هذاك جملة من الليلة هذيك، معناها ما بقيتش خم غدوة شنو باش يصير لي، معناها كان معناها في الليلة الأولى هذيك هكاك ما لم بعد كيفاش.
December 18th, 2010, Tunisia, the first Arab nation to witness revolution. Women are on the front lines of the protest movement. By January 2011, Ben Ali was gone. October 23rd, 2011. The country is now experiencing democracy. About 5,000 women have run in the October 2011 elections. At the moment, 27% of representatives in the National Constituent Assembly are women. Although Tunisian women have been able to vote from 1959, prior to the revolution, their civil and political rights were ignored by Tunisian governments. The uprising was an opportunity for Tunisian women to enter the public arena.
The women was used as a decor, just to show to the force, exterior forces, here there is some women participating with us in the political decision, but in fact they don't give any opinions or any decisions. But now, thank God, it's all changed, because this has become a reality. Now, our constitutional assembly is it's constitute of 15% women, 50% men. 99% of those women wearing al-hijab, and those women are written now the new constitution of the country. They're written, in fact, the new history of our country. So I'm proud now of what Tunis, in the level of the women's right, had become.
أربعة مصريين ولعوا في نفسهم من الذل ومن الجوع ومن الفقر ومن البهدلة اللي شايفينها بقالهم 30 سنة.
This video, posted by Asma Mahfouz on Facebook, drove thousands of people to Tahrir Square, a place which was to become the symbol of Egypt's popular uprising. Demonstrations, marches, acts of civil disobedience and labor strikes. Millions of protesters from all walks of life took to the streets to provoke change. The 25th of November 2011. Prayers are held in Tahrir Square on what is being called Last Chance Friday. Activists say it's going to be the event that rams the message home after a week of protests that saw 41 people killed. Demonstrators are demanding a new constitution and a speedy transfer of power to a civilian government. The revolution came at a price. There were violent clashes between security forces and protesters. 900 people were killed and 6,000 injured. But national TV did not reflect what was really happening in the country. Soha al-Nakash, an Egyptian news anchor, resigned from Nile News Channel after 20 years. She said she couldn't go on working for a network that was lying to the people by downplaying the severity of the situation. The 23rd and 24th of May 2012, Egyptian women claiming their share of democracy.
December 10th, 2011, Oslo. The Norwegian Nobel Committee has a surprise. Tavakkal Karaman, a 30-year-old activist, is among the winners.
I accept this award on my behalf and on behalf of the Yemeni and Arab revolutionary youth who are leading today's peaceful struggle against tyranny and corruption with moral courage and wisdom.
Her arrest by Saleh's regime set off days of major street demonstrations that threatened his hold on power. Behind Tavakkal now stand thousands of Yemeni women who have come to claim their right in determining the future of a truly democratic Yemen, one in which they can benefit from an equal share. Along with Egypt's Hosni Mubarak, the bell was also tolled for Yemen's Ali Abdullah Saleh. Unemployment, economic strife, and corruption sparked a storm of protests which eventually led to the resignation of the Yemeni president.
March 26, 2011. Tripoli, Libya. A woman is surrounded by security guards and hotel staff. Someone is trying to cover her head. Iman al-Obaid. She claims she's been detained at a checkpoint where she was raped by 15 men and held for 2 days.
Ma'amar al-Mujrim. Ibnati Rahina. ابنتي الرهينة في يد الظلم الظلام المجرمين الخونة ومعمر القذافي وأتباعه وابني ابني على رأس نلوف
Colonel Muammar Gaddafi's bodyguards, female bodyguards. This might suggest equality among the sexes, but these women certainly did not represent their country women. Inspired by the revolutions in Tunisia and Egypt, movements are forming in Libya. People are demanding freedom and civil rights. Demonstrations, protests, and then civil war. Women are seen at the heart of the struggle throughout. Fadwa, a Libyan journalist in Tripoli, her sister Hajar and her mother Umm Tawar were involved in armed combat with Gaddafi's forces. Faiza and Haifa are two young women from Benghazi who worked as nurses and administrative directors in the Al-Jala's hospital during the uprising. they witnessed not only the protests and the violence that followed, but the human cost of war on a daily basis.
ما يقارب عن 2000 أو 3000 حالة جريح يعني كان المستشفى يشتغل 24 ساعة طيلة 24 ساعة ما بيت داخل المستشفى بالنسبة للممرضات بصفة عامة ما فيش غياب يعني حضور بشكل مكثف بالنسبة للتمريض كنساء وقدم دور يعني عظيم جدا جدا حتى متطوعات عندنا من النساء مختلف الأعمار حتى في من السن الكبيرة بالنسبة للمرأة يعني ممكن تتجاوز 70 سنة أو 60 سنة
After the 2011 revolution in Libya, Libyan women have had a greater role in society and government. There are small but very active groups of women across the country who expect to take their place in the leadership of the new Libya. 33 women were elected to serve in Libya's General National Congress in the first free elections. Other women-dominated groups are working to restart the health and education sectors.
Many believe that the fact that Iran's 1979 Islamic Revolution was a success inspired freedom fighters in the Middle East and North Africa. Women had a vivid role in Iran's revolution as well.
When you take a look at the history of the Islamic Awakening in Iran, you could see that in the different meetings and the rally that we had in the past, our women used to be the pioneer of the rally and holding the meeting against the former regime. In the northern part of Africa, in Egypt and Tunisia, you could see that women played very important role. If it is so, it means that our women are aware about the role that they can play, not only in the creation of the revolution in their own country, but also the preservation of what they got after the revolution.
ما اول جلوی تقریبا جلوی صف خانم‌ها بودیم که بعد چند تا تیر هوایی زدن بعد یه مقدار شلوغ شدش شلوغ که شدش یه عده‌ای زیر دست پا رفتن و اینا ولی یه ماشینی بودش با خانوما که به حساب شعارا رو تنظیم میکردن گفتن که انگار که ارتش اعلام هم بستگی کرده و شلوغ نکنین همینجا سر جاتون باشه
همه ما که اینجا جمع شدیم میخوایم نشون بدیم که چقدر از این سیستم فاسد مخصوصا سیستم سلطنتی همین مشروطه سلطنتی که حالا دارن عنوان میکنن به عنوان قانون اساسی دارن تحویل ما میدن واقعا منزجر و بیزاری در درجه اول و بعد هم که مسلمه که کشتاری که دیروز به دستور آقای شاپور بختیار به قول خودش حکومت ملی و سوسیال دموکرات داره انجام میده تنفر خودمون رو نسبت به اون ثابت بکنیم و بعد فرزندای خودمون رو برادران خودمون و پسران خودمون رو از مرگ حتمی که ممکن در اثر کمبود خون بهشون دست بده نجات بدیم و ثابت کنیم که اتحاد و همبستگی ما هیچ وقت گسستنی نیست، حتی اگر تمام مردم ایران هم بخوان با گلوله و مسلسل و توپ و تانکی که به وسیله امریکا با خون ملت، با خونی که در تمام رگ‌های ما جریان داره خریدن، باز به طرف خودمون میگیرن، اونها رو در واقع از بین ببریم و ثابت بکنیم که هیچ وقت ملت ایران و هیچ ملتی از بین رفتنی نیست.
July 10th, 2012, Tehran. The first international conference on women and the Islamic awakening. More than 1,500 female researchers and scholars, as well as political and social activists from more than 80 countries are taking part.
Invited to attend this conference because it is about the role of women in this age, and as you know that we have so many revolutions in our Arab world. So from Egypt they have taken 55 women to share this program to talk about our revolution and how women can participate in awakening the society and the awareness of society to social and political issues.
Hijab, wearing chadar, they have a very strong personality. They speak their mind, and they are so well educated.
موفقیت‌های خیلی زیادی رو در جامعه ایران مدیون زنان هستیم و از نظر ادبیات، از نظر کالاهای فرهنگی اکثرا زنان در تولید اون چه فرهنگی و چه اقتصادی شرکت دارن. ممکنه که زنان منطقه با نگاه تعصب‌آمیز به زن ایرانی نگاه کنن و اما نمیتونن منکر این باشن که زن ایرانی توانمندی‌های بالایی داره و تونسته موفقیت‌هایی به دست بیاره که زنان کشورهای منطقه این توانمندی‌ها رو نتونستن در کشور خودشون به دست بیارن، علی‌رغم اینکه از نظر ایدئولوژیکی در حد ما بودند.
On avait, comme tous les autres pays arabes, musulmans et occidentaux, l'image que nous a inculqué les médias occidentaux et les médias qui sont amis avec les occidentaux. On avait tous une image assez fausse qui prend la femme iranienne pour une femme opprimée. Une femme négligée, une femme qui subit beaucoup de violences, une femme qui ne joue aucun rôle dans la société, qui est toujours derrière les hommes. Personnellement, je savais que c'était faux, malgré qu'on trouve dans tous les films qu'il y a toujours un passage, un petit passage, même une seconde, quelque chose qui montre que la femme iranienne est soumise.
Islam has re-emerged as a political force since the Tunisian Revolution in 2011, and among other things has influenced the rights and the future of many women profoundly. The Islamic awakening has shattered the stereotypical image of Muslims in general and the image of the Muslim woman in particular. Far from being passive spectators, Muslim women from Iran to Tunisia, Egypt, Bahrain, Yemen, and Libya have been participating in all stages, levels, and fields of the revolutions. And an important part of their mission was making headlines worldwide to further their cause, a decision that cost them many lives. Now, Muslim women are full of hope and look forward to the day when they are the masters of their own destiny. Square. The streets of Tunis, Sana'a and Tripoli. Women and men side by side marching together, defying government forces. They're calling for reform and regime change.
About anti-regime protests in Bahrain. She was arrested three more times when protesting with other women. The Bahraini uprisings were initially aimed at
the Muslim world. Women have stepped into the forefront of dangerous anti-regime protests. Women are now actively participating in the pursuit of freedom, dignity, and social justice, shoulder to shoulder with men. For years, women in these countries have suffered gender discrimination. Throughout history, they have been marginalized by totalitarian regimes. According to the Arab Human Development Report in 2002, the lack of women's rights was one of the main stumbling blocks hampering the region's progress. But in the past few years, things have changed. Across the
December 15, 2011, the outskirts of Manama. A police officer is dragging a girl on the ground. She is not a criminal. Her name is Zainab Al-Khawaja, a Bahraini human rights activist and the daughter of Abdul Hadi Al-Khawaja, a prominent Bahraini Danish human rights activist. Her name grabbed headlines after she posted tweets online.